Good evening. Let's try that again. Good evening. All the way from orchestra to dress circle to grand tier. I'm so glad to see this house full. After 3 years of hiatus, we're back. Isn't it good to be back? We've missed you. I'm glad you're here, and I know your students are just very excited to be performing with you. My name is Michael Smith, and I'm the director of the Desley Fine Arts Education Collaborative. And as I said, we're just so happy you're here. This has been a busy building today. We've had visual artists and musicians working hard and rehearsing, and they're very excited to share with you what they have accomplished today. I must say, from the very beginning, this has been a phenomenal group of students. They have been so attentive, so receptive, and just so wonderful to work with. I know each one of the clinicians will back me up on that and may even comment about that as well. This was really special. You have some special young people here. As the banner on the side of the other side of the stage says, we Desley endowed professors work hard to connect St. Louis through educational and community partnerships. And we, like our namesake, E. Desmond Lee, believe that education matters. Further, we in the Desley Fine Arts Education Collaborative believe that the arts matter. And we know that music and arts matter to you as well. You're here. Thank you for your support. Thank you for being here this evening, of course. But even more, thank you for all the support you provide these students throughout the year, day after day. The arts, music, drama, visual arts, dance, these aren't just frills in the school curriculum. We believe. They're not extra, nor are they extracurricular. From research and personal experience, we know that the arts help us all, including these wonderful students, to live lives that are richer because of their study of the arts. Research shows that music and the other arts sharpen our minds. They help us to think more carefully. The arts touch our hearts, helping us to feel more deeply. And through wonderful experiences such as this festival, the arts help us to share more generously with one another. New friends and acquaintances have been made here today throughout this festival day and continue now as we gather in this beautiful concert hall and celebrate the results of this day's activities and just the chance to be together. Events such as this don't happen just by happenstance. They take a lot of planning and a lot of support. And I'd like to offer some thanks, first of all, to Ms. Patricia Zahn, Director of Community Engagement and Development here at the University of Missouri, St. Louis. I'd also like to thank Professor Joanna Mendoza, Music Department Chair, for her unflagging support of the Collaborative and for the many other fine programs here at the Music Department here at UMSL. Of course, we remember E. Desmond Lee, whose vision and generosity helped to create the Desley Fine Arts Education Collaborative. And thank you as well to UMSL Chancellor Kristen Sobolik, Dean Frank Grady, and to the other UMSL administrators who tangibly support this evening's event and others like it through ongoing university funding and staffing support. And an enormous thank you to the Two Hill staff. They have been phenomenal. We have a full crew here. They're back and well and running this place like clockwork, and they've just been terrific today. So thank you, Two Hill staff, very much. We'd also like to sincerely thank another very important group of people, and those would be the music teachers and the visual arts teachers who are here with us this evening. They too have been here all day, and just as they show up day in and day out, they've shown up here. Throughout the school year, they support your students, they teach, and they encourage. I'd like to ask all the music and art teachers who are here in this hall tonight, would you please stand so you can be recognized for your good work? Thanks to each and every one of you. You may not get the glory that you deserve, but I consider you all to be rock stars. You're just awesome. I'd also like to offer my sincere and great appreciation to the chairs and organizers of each of the festival groups that you'll hear performing this evening. They'll each be introducing their groups, and you'll have a chance to hear from each of these chairpersons as they introduce their groups. And they have worked hard and long, and I thank them very much. And finally, but certainly not least of all, thank you to you the parents, families, and friends of these fine students. I know that the clinicians also join me in telling you what a delight they have been to work with today. A festival evening like this would not be possible without your support, so I applaud you and invite you to give yourselves a well-earned round of applause. To begin this evening's program, I would like to introduce the chair of the 2023 Desley Festival Choir. The St. Louis Children's Choir has partnered with the Collaborative this year to support the Festival Choir. Please join me in welcoming to the stage Ms. Olivia Leek of the St. Louis Children's Choir, Artistic Coordinator and Festival Chair Coordinator, Ms. Olivia Leek.
Well, thank you so much for coming tonight. We're so happy to have you here with us. Oh, it's such a full crowd tonight. It's amazing. As Dr. Smith said, my name is Olivia Leek. I'm the Artistic Coordinator for the St. Louis Children's Choirs and the Chair for the Desley Festival Middle School Honor Choir. SLCC is very honored to partner with the Desley Collaborative and Dr. Smith to make this festival possible and to bring this lovely performance to you tonight. Conducting the middle school choir tonight is Maria Ellis, owner of the Girl Conductor LLC, director of the Sheldon's All-Star Chorus, and host of the award-winning show Bach and Beyonce on Classic 107.3. Lastly, I just want to thank all the directors and the choir teachers for helping us out today. We could not have done this without you. Thank you so much. Thank you to all of you again for being here tonight. And without further ado, please welcome the Desley Festival Middle School Honor Choir.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. It has been an honor and a privilege to serve as the conductor for the Desmond Middle School Middle School Festival Choir. They have been amazing. Will you all give them another hand, please? Let me tell you what this day entails. They arrived this morning at 11 o'clock. Some of them came with music that they already learned. Some of them came with music that they all learned today. But they have been phenomenal musicians, and I'm so honored that I've had the opportunity to work with them. The Desley Festival is always special to me as I am a graduate of Riverview Gardens High School, which is in North County. All right, View Time, I hear you out there. I hear you out there. But also because I'm a graduate of the University of Missouri, St. Louis, so it's just like being at home. The last piece that we perform for you tonight is called It's All Right. It's from the soundtrack Soul. Now, there is a portion where the students are going to ask you to clap your hands, and I'm going to be very, I want to make sure that we get this right, okay? We're going to ask you to clap your hands, but you can only clap on beats 2 and 4, okay? This is not a 1 and 3 type of deal. So if you cannot clap on 1 and 3, we're going to ask you to sit this one out and let the 2 and 4s hold it down. This is It's All Right. Again, thank you so much. The choir has been amazing. I definitely appreciate you all time. Thank you so much.
How about that choir? And how about you hand clappers? You got better as it went along. You did. You got better. I heard you. The Desley Fine Arts Festival is but one aspect of the work and activities of the Desley Fine Arts Education Collaborative. Through the collaborative, students and teachers from the Desmond schools and school districts have opportunities to participate in many experiences, such as in-school master classes, field trips to concerts, recitals, plays, and art gallery visits that are provided by a number of outstanding St. Louis fine arts organizations. These organizations are listed toward the back of your program, and I'd invite you to look at those and check them out. We would like to feature one of these collaborative partners tonight. The St. Louis Children's Choir Men's Chorus, under the direction of Dr. John McDonald, Linda Raddick, accompanist. Please welcome Dr. McDonald.
Good evening. My name is Dr. John McDonald, and this is the St. Louis Children's Choir Young Men's Chorus. We are so thankful to be here tonight. Give another round of applause. I'd like to thank Michael Smith and Des Lee for inviting us to be a part of this wonderful event this evening, and thank you all for being here. As I said, the Young Men's Chorus is part of the grander St. Louis Children's Chorus. This group is ranging from 6th grade through 12th grade. This is a place for changed voice tenor bass singers. Some of these students started as treble singers in our treble ensembles and transitioned into this ensemble. Some of them joined in this ensemble brand new to the St. Louis Children's Choirs. If you or someone you know would be interested in joining St. Louis Children's Choir, you can find us at SLCC Sing. That's SLCC the word sing.org. Lots of information on there, but also we'd invite anyone to check out auditioning and joining this wonderful organization. Tonight we have kind of an array, a sampling of some of the pieces this group has learned and performed over the last year. The song you just heard, Sansa Chroma, is an African children's game song. Next we have a lovely romantic piece, which all tenor bass choruses enjoy singing, titled Passing By. And following that, an Irish working song, Fila Mi Orie. Okay, conducting without a stand is only good for one piece. I'm gonna grab a stand and then we'll continue on with the program.
I put my corduroy breeches on. I put my corduroy breeches on to work upon the railway. Fill me ori ori eh, fill me ori ori eh, fill me ori ori eh, to work upon the railway. In 1842, I left the old before the new. To a sorry luck that brought me through to work upon the railway. Fill me ori ori eh, fill me ori ori eh. Ori, ori, eh, to work upon the railway.
In 1943, 'twas then I met sweet Biddy McGee, an elegant wife she's been to me while working on the railway.
It's pat to this and pat to that, without a stop me over that, and nothing but an ultra hat while working on the railway. 1844, how could I know what was in store? Belly empty, hands so sore, work so hard, but they want more. In 1845, I did not like to be alive, iron rails that I must drive while working on the railway. The day is done, 'tis time to sleep, but critters round my heart to creep. Bones so tired, I cannot weep, I'm weary of the railway.
The Irish working song, Fill Me Aurea, featured soloist Liam Stewart. Give Liam another hand. And the last piece was a round created from the chorus of Andy Grammer's Fine By Me, for those of you Andy Grammer fans out there. Our last piece is the very popular gospel piece by Keith Hampton, Praise His Holy Name. It will feature soloists Matthias Herman and Noah Parker. I'm so glad that my good friend Maria taught you all how to clap earlier, because you're going to be called upon once again to join us, if the Spirit moves, at the end of this piece, to help in that same fashion. So I don't have to talk about 1 and 3. You've already gotten that part down pat, so you're good to go on that. I'd like to also acknowledge our wonderful collaborative pianist, Mrs. Linda Raddick. And again, thank you so much for the invitation to join you tonight. Thank you for all of you for being here and for supporting music and supporting the arts. And we'd love to have you at St. Louis Children's Choir, slccsing.org. And thanks again. Enjoy Praise His Holy Name by Keith Hampton.
Like me, I once was lost, but now I'm found. Was blind, but now I see.
Jesus, Jesus, how I love thee. Shouts hallelujah, praise his holy name. Sing till the power of the Lord come down. Shouts hallelujah, praise his holy name. Sing till the power of the Lord. Shout hallelujah, praise his holy name.
Does Jesus bear the cross alone and all the world go free? No, there's a cross for everyone and there's a cross for me.
Jesus, Jesus, how I love thee. Shout hallelujah, praise his holy name. Sing till the power of the Lord come down. Shout hallelujah, praise his holy name. Sing till the power of the Lord come down. Shout hallelujah, praise his holy name.
Indeed, he deserves a round of applause, and so do all the folk behind here. So a little backstage scoop. We just took 145 children off the stage and choral risers, and another, not that many, 100 orchestral members came in, and no one got hurt, I don't think. We're doing well. Yeah. And how about your hand clapping? You're just showing off now. Yeah. We'd like to continue with the Festival Orchestra, and I would like to introduce to you the chair of the Festival Orchestra, Ms. Robin Veale.
Good evening. Welcome to our orchestra concert part of the evening, and my name's Robin Veale, as he said. I'm the Middle School Orchestra Festival Chair for the E. Desmond Lee Fine Arts Collaborative, and I'm here to introduce the orchestra. But first, I have a couple of thank yous that I'd like to make. First of all, for E. Desmond Lee to give the students this wonderful opportunity to get together for such a great day and rehearse and perform on a beautiful stage in a beautiful auditorium. This is a real treat for our students. Secondly, to all of you, all of our parents who have supported your students in the music program and came here this evening and made sure they had their instruments and made sure they had their clothes and all of the things that go along with supporting your students. We could not do this without you. So thank you, the parents, for all of your support. Thank you. To the Two Hill staff, for their tireless work in helping us get ready. They are amazing. To see what they do back here is nothing short of amazing, so we'd like to thank them as well. All of our middle school orchestra teachers for helping our students get ready for the day, we could not do this without them. They rehearse the music, they get their students prepared. We had a whole host of teachers helping with sectionals today. I'd like to thank Laura Hune, Shaylin Morgan, Sarah Velasquez, Ali Custer Baggett, Leanna Conrad, Tyler Moore, Caitlin Peach, Eliana Haig, Kathy Van Winkle, and Joseph Pauly. They put in some extra work this afternoon rehearsing our students. I'd like to thank Linda Huck, our band festival chair. She loaned us some wonderful percussion students who are going to help us out on some pieces tonight. And finally, our conductor for today, Mrs. Michelle Howard. She has done such a great job rehearsing the students and getting them ready to play for you. A very talented musician and a wonderful teacher. It's just been a great day watching her work with all these students. So we hope you enjoy the concert tonight. And without any further ado, I'd like to introduce the 2023 E. Desmond Lee Middle School Festival Orchestra under the direction of Mrs. Michelle Howard. Thank you.
I hope you all had an opportunity to tour the Fine Arts Gallery earlier this evening. If you didn't have the opportunity, I'm sorry the opportunity's passed. That was a little bit of an ephemeral experience. It was taped on the windows, and the two Hilastas to take those down. But they did an amazing job, and we can capture all of that, and we have, and we'll share that in just a moment. These talented young artists work really hard, and they came up with some amazing, amazing products. They were all under the guidance of their clinician, and I'd like to welcome that clinician, my colleague, the art education professor here at the University of Missouri, St. Louis. Please welcome Dr. Jennifer Fisher.
It is always so great to be here at the Desley Fine Arts Festival. It's one of my favorite days, or two of my favorite days, rather. We had high school yesterday of the year. And, you know, sometimes in the visual arts, it's a little bit more difficult to see some of the great things that our students are doing. Because it's easy to go to a basketball game and watch a basketball team. It's easy to go to a concert and see your students perform. And sometimes it can be a little bit more difficult to highlight the great work that our visual art students are doing. So a few years ago, whenever Dr. Smith approached me and said, hey, this is a fine arts festival. Can you bring the art students? And I said, I guess we're gonna find out. And so for the past several years, we've been really fortunate to have our visual art students come at both the middle school and high school level. And when I tell you these kids are talented, I mean these kids are talented. Our teachers are able to bring some of the best and brightest, most talented young artists from their schools. And when you see what they put together in just three or four short hours today with nothing but tape, I think you'll be very impressed. The theme for this year was Ignite. So when I gave the students that prompt of Ignite, I said, you can take that prompt and run with it. And it's always fun to see that our students create things that are so completely different from one another, all beginning from the same theme. We will also be showing our Best in Show this evening, and the student who is the Best in Show winner will be able to participate in a visual arts gallery here on campus at UMSL with some of our art education students later this year. You know, one of the interesting things, this has never happened before. My judge who came and decided our Best of Show, because I don't do it, I don't want to be biased, said, you know, I think we really need some honorable mentions because this is tough. And I said, yeah, that's why I don't want to do it. And so you will see that we had several students actually win honorable mention awards this year. I'm so excited to show this to you. I hope you enjoy it. And parents, friends, and family, thank you so much for supporting your visual arts students.
Thank you. Good evening, everyone. My name is Linda Huck, and I am the festival chair for the E. Desmond Lee Middle School Honor Band. I know that you've heard a lot of thank yous tonight, but I really feel it's important to recognize some of the same groups for this ensemble as well, because everybody has worked hard to make this event happen today. I'd like to thank the collaborative, the E. Desmond Lee Collaborative, under the leadership of Dr. Michael Smith, for helping us actually have this. And it's great to be back, especially after several years of not being able to get together in person. The Two Hill staff, the stage crew, they are amazing. I know you've heard that from everybody else, but they are truly amazing. We appreciate them so much. The band directors of these students that you're going to see this evening worked hard to help their students prepare the music before they arrived here. So we'd like to support them and thank the band directors. And parents, please continue to support those music teachers in your schools. They work so hard. And I know myself because I'm a former band director. And the band director brain does not turn off when you go home at night. Sometimes it even goes at 3 o'clock in the morning. Because you're always thinking about your students and the next event and what you can do to help them. So please give them all of your support. Parents, thank you so much for allowing your students to be a part of this activity. It is so worthwhile. It teaches so much more than just how to read black notes on a page. So thank you for your support. As other people have said, the students today have been magnificent. They've been quiet when they needed to be. They've listened and absorbed knowledge today. They've come back on time from breaks, which is wonderful. We just really had a great day today. Our conductor for the E. Des Lee Middle School Honor Band, Dr. David Wacyk, is the band director here at UMSL. He has done just an amazing job with the students today. He has given them so much knowledge that they can take back with them to their own schools. He's been engaging, he's been positive, enthusiastic, and the students and he have just had a wonderful time. So I think that you're going to be in for a treat. Please welcome to the stage Dr. David Wacyk and the 2023 E. Desmond Lee Middle School Festival Band.
We've all been here for a very long time enjoying some amazing music and art, so I will be very brief, and we have three relatively short band pieces to play, and then we can head out. But this has been a fantastic day, and I want you just to imagine something. I'm a parent, and this is hard for me to imagine. Imagine you're at home, and you sit your child down, and you say, you're going to do one thing and not move for 4.5 hours, and you're not gonna get up and change activities until we all decide it's good enough. That doesn't usually happen, right? And that happened today, and nobody complained, ever. We talked about professionalism a lot today, being a professional musician, and that has very little to do with correct notes and rhythms, although we worked a lot on that. It has a little bit to do with playing with the right style, and we worked a lot on that, but it mostly has to do with how they carry themselves as individuals, how they treat each other as human beings, and if they are here on time and ready to work, and they are very professional, and so you should be very proud of them like I am. The only complaint that I received was by one person, and it wasn't even really a complaint. It was so polite. They said, "Dr. Wacyk, when do you think our next break will be? Because some of us are getting a little bit tired." And this is at the end of the day. So that gives you an idea of how positive they've been. We have some really great band pieces, and they are A Jubilant Spirit by Carol Britton Chambers, Ember Skies by Kevin Day, and Havoc by Salvador Allen Jacobo. Please enjoy.
Thank you. They were terrific. Thank you all. We're not going to drop the curtain because they kind of scooted out and we don't want to hit them with the curtain. So, you know, we don't want to lose any children. We've gotten this far. We need to make it all the way to the end. One other little piece of request, please. These children are going to find their way off the stage, and about 450 children will be finding their way out into the lobby. And if you all go out to the lobby at the same time, it's just kind of a mess. So just take your time, take a breath, and kind of ease out, and we'll find one another right out in the lobby. And I hope we find you out here again in 2024, February 6th and 7th. Mark your calendars, it's not too early. Thanks for coming. Thanks for coming. Drive safely. And do take your children home, please. Thank you very much.